Hello. Goodbye. Out of my face. Alright, bro. Back up! Back up! Back up! 1 second. Ugh. If we're done here, please tell me, because I'm sick of this. Bruh. Make it through the woods. Yay! Okay, then what do I do? Oh my gosh, bro. Alright. Oh, makes sense. And we got bats! Lovely. Revolver ammo. Hunting rifle ammo. Perfect. Not you again. I'm gonna ask you nicely again. Back up. There's two of you now. Wonderful. Up. 1 second. Oh, come on. Ah, what are you, some sort of football player? I hate lumberjacks. Awesome. Where do I go? I just push it open? Yeah, another lumberjack. Wait, what? Now they have chainsaws?! Alright! None of this nonsense! Oh, he's a big dude, too. Get out! Get me out! Dude, just freaking dodge! No! Oh my gosh, bro! Really hoping it was a lumberjack and not some crazed man with a chainsaw. You next, big guy. I'm gonna ask you nicely to back up! Alright, look, just for running. Back up. Not a big enough light. I need a flare. No, please reload. Huh. Are we finally out of the woods?
Stay out of sight. I'm on my way. Don't open the door.
What, am I crazy?
Stay hidden. I'll be there soon. Just make sure you keep the lights on. I still had to reach Barry at the cabin, but at least I was out of the woods.
Nah, bro. I'm sick of the woods. Is this area blocked?
I'd have to get the car from the locked garage. It would get me back to Barry faster. And the headlights were a welcome bonus.
They were a very welcome bonus. But don't freaking jinx it. Found him. Back up! Just had to write books, huh? I'm gonna enter the vehicle. What do you think I'm doing? Do I actually get to drive? Yes! Out the way! Back up! Are you kidding me? Nah, man, these vehicle controls are perfect. I don't know what you want. It's a bit sluggish, but hey, it's good enough. Where the heck is Barry? How far did I go into the woods? Oh, you're evil for that. Move out the way. Can't be serious. Oh, fuck! Oh, come on, man!
Kidnapper.
You son of a bitch! Where's my wife?
Enough horseplay, Wake! You deliver the manuscript, and you can have your woman back. Simple as that.
I don't... Listen. I'm gonna need time to finish it. I still need to write the ending. I need... a week.
Not done?
I need a week.
2 days! The old Bright Falls coal mine is nearby. You can find it easy, city boy. The main building, there at noon. You bring the manuscript, you'll get your wife. Not, well, get me.
Yes, I get you.
Welcome back to the show, folks. As promised, our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio. God,
I like being here. I liked being in the car a lot better, but no, I just had to be blocked off the road. Oh no. What the fuck?
Barry had talked about birds over the phone.
have a flare gun now? About dang time. Yeah! Uh-huh.
These birds are weird.
Oh, man. Birds? Alright. I have to fight birds now? Yeah! Yeah. Probably I'll try to do that. No promises, though. Oh, hey, guys. Yeah! Where's the flare gun? You got anything else out here I could use? Is that a hot tub? What do you... How... Why are you even up here? Come on, come on, come on. Hey! Yeah! Yeah! That's not enough. What the f- This is stupid. Bit. I hate this game with a pitch. Yeah! Back up! Back up! Back up! Oh, come on. Oh, come on, no! This is the dumbest thing ever. Getting attacked by freaking birds is stupid. I'm not shooting all these birds at once. Wait a minute. Ah! Dang it! Get in the shed! What the fuck? Yeah, y'all birds want some? I got some for the ass. I'm sorry. Oh, come on! Ah! I hate this game. Shut up! Gosh. Nah, don't you go away from me! Oh, man. I'm gonna go find more flare ammo. No! There's nothing in here. Better back up. Yeah, it's like a camera flash. It would be coming real handy. Ow! No, please. Ah! Yeah, eat light, you stupid. Oh no. Ow, ow, ow! Hey! Back up! Oh my gosh. I'm gonna kill you, Barry. I'm gonna kill you.
Al, I'm sorry for thinking you were having a psychotic episode, man.
I'm gonna shoot you. Over some dang birds.
Ask around about a man fitting the kidnapper's description. He'd go through the archives of the local paper. Perhaps he could learn something. Anything about the island and the cabin that had disappeared. The man wanted a manuscript. I had to try to write him one to get Alice back. For me, the supernatural had always been nothing but a metaphor for the human psyche, a tool to use in writing fiction. Now, it was happening for real, and I couldn't put a single word on paper.
Barry Wheeler speaking.
This is Rose.
Rose?
I found Mr. Waite's pages.
Oh, you sweet, brilliant girl.
Could you and Mr. Waite come get them? I live in the trailer park outside the town.
We'll be there in less than an hour.
Kinda.
See you soon.
Have a great day.
Oh, no.
Hope you come back soon. Welcome to the old dear diary.
Good girl.
Previously on Alan Wake, Alice has been kidnapped.
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
I can't tell anyone except my agent, Barry.
Damn it, Barry, they'll kill her.
You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head.
The ransom is a manuscript I supposedly wrote that's coming true before my eyes.
It happened just the way it was on that page. So dark.
I have found only a few scattered pages.
I want the entire manuscript.
The deadline is in 2 days.
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Good girl.
How the hell did she get her hands on the manuscript anyway?
I don't know. She's resourceful. I told you you were too hard on her. Listen, I found out all sorts of interesting stuff while I was digging around.
Yeah.
Mr. Wake, it's Sheriff Breaker. We have an FBI agent here, Agent Nightingale.
FBI?
He's anxious to see you. You'd better come to the station.
Okay, I'll be right over, Sheriff. Let's make this quick, huh?
Help you folks? Name's Randolph. I'm the manager.
We're looking for Rose. Works as a waitress down at the diner.
Rose, sure. Nice girl. Who wants to know?
I'm Alan Wake.
The writer, huh? I heard on the radio you were busy. Well, I'll show you her trailer. That Rose, she's a nice girl. Always pays her rent on time.
As I was saying, Al, I found all sorts of weird stuff from the local newspaper's archives. This place is crazy. Disappearances, mysterious deaths, urban legends come true, and get this, most of this stuff takes place around Cauldron Lake.
Well, you ain't wrong, mister. The Indians thought the lake was a doorway to the underworld. I'm the God-fearing type myself. I don't hold with that sort of thing.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, there was an island there owned by a guy called Thomas Zink. Now, some of the articles I found about him make him out to be a famous writer, but I ran a bunch of searches, couldn't find a single thing he wrote. Zane was heavily into diving, so much so that the place came to be called Diver's Isle. But the volcano under the lake erupted in 1970, and Zane went down with the island. It's better. A local girl, Barbara Jagger, drowned in Cauldron Lake just a week earlier. They were lovers.
Sure, Jagger's a local spook store. The scratching hag comes for you in the dark. Childish stuff like that.
Anyway, Al, I'm just getting to the best part. All of the articles about this stuff were written by Cynthia Weaver. I asked around, and she's that crazy bag lady you met.
What, the lamp lady? She can be a little loopy, but she's not homeless or...
Yeah, anyway, she knew both Jagger and Zane before they both died, and she had some kind of a breakdown.
Well, mister, this here's Rose's trailer. You mind me asking what you want with her?
We're just here to talk to her, pal.
Welcome to... Oh dear, Mr. Wake. I'm so glad you're here.
Rose, you have my manuscript?
Oh yes. Yes. Please, come in.
Hey, this is really good.
Rose.
Yes.
My manuscript. I really need it.
I understand. I know what you need. A muse to inspire you.
Oh, for Barry. She doesn't have anything.
Yeah. Hey, Al. Al, what's... Oh.
Barry! What?
It's coming for you, hiding in my barber's skin. I'm too weak to stop it. You must turn the lights on.
I promised I'd come visit you and your lovely wife. You must finish what you started. I insist.
You must turn the lights on. Turn the light on.
Back to work, boy.
Not again.
I felt nauseous, hungover. Only anger kept me going. Rose took a day from me. I had less than 12 hours left to meet the kidnapper. All I could do was get Barry into the car, work something out once I got on the road. Barry was out of it. He was way too heavy to carry.
You're right. Deserve more. So handsome.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner. What can I get you today? Coffee?
I couldn't work up much hate for Rose. Something had used her to get to me and left its mark. My gun and flashlight were gone. I'd have to find a way to get Barry into the car as quickly as possible. There was no time to waste.
I had to actually fight people, right?
Gonna get it now.
What?
God knows what you've done to that poor girl. This is Agent Nightingale, FBI. Get him up, Hemingway. You're under arrest. You move a muscle, I'll unload right in your goddamn face. Stay right where you are, Blaine.
What is wrong with you, man?
Yeah, I'm standing right here, you goddamn maniac.
I hated to leave Barry behind, but there was no way I'd miss my appointment with the kidnapper.
I lost him. Not now. Awesome.
This horror was everywhere I went, circling me. The cops didn't stand a chance. They were after a writer, not a monster.
What?
I imagined that the broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station. Main seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine.
Maybe not.
Unnatural shadows clung to the gate. The darkness that was after me was trying to stop me. I wouldn't get through without it.
Smart.
There was no power to the searchlight.
Not again. What? What? Oh, heck no. Nope. I'm good. This'll do. Oh, yeah. Open wide.
It took me a moment to recognize the flashbang grenades. They were an ideal weapon for my situation.
Team 1, come in. Over.
Hey, flashbang, sucker! Goodbye. These flashbangs are 10 times better than the flares. Yes! Three parts? Four parts? Whatever. Oh, hey, gents. We close? Oh my. Get out of here! Get out of here!
Maine could lend me a car to get to the coal mine.
Move.
Here's a little surprise. The famous writer Alan Wake just walked in, folks. I'm gonna see if I can talk him into an interview.
Thank you. Yeah, hello. Oh,
I'm so glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
Nowhere to run now, Dan Brown. You back away from me. Don't hurt.
Whoa. Everyone calm down.
Put the gun down. We're all friends here, right?
Cool your jets, Nightingale. We got him. What the hell's the matter with you? There's a civilian in there.
Never ends, does it? I hope it kills you. No, I don't.
I had fallen off so many cliffs, it was ridiculous. That's what you get for naming a book The Sudden Stop. It was probably good I hadn't had the chance to tell Maine where I was going. I'd have to lose the cops and find my own way to the mine.
More flares, yeah. Oh, this is perfect. Yeah! I'm safe now from you mother chuckers! Ha ha! Yeah! Oh, and I got a gun now. Bring him, you mother smuckers. Where you at? That's what I thought. I'm outie. A second. I'm even mad about it.
There was no sensible reason for the power company work lights to be here. It was almost as if they'd been left for someone like me to use.
Oh, nice. Look at that. Gotta find something in this bad room. Even better. Give me this bad boy. Joke's on you. I love that thing. Wait a minute. Yeah! We done here? Good. Good. Oh, come on. I'm gonna keep it a buck with you. I don't really like fighting y'all constantly. It's getting old. Real fast. Just pick this up. Train? Train! Give me all this stuff first. Yeah, give it all. No, come back, train!
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice? Alice?
Alan, I'm so afraid. It keeps me in the dark. Please help me. I look at you, Alan, and it's not you. It's something else. Looking out from behind your eyes.
Alice, I'm here.
I'm so alone here. It's all gonna go to hell. You need to be careful. Cooperate.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me. I could see a railway bridge up ahead, and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there.
I hope I can find a car. Sick of all this moving. And the farce! I don't hate the farce. No, I hate the farce. Who am I kidding? I really hate the farce. No. I'll think of this. Rusty pipes, don't you think?
The darkness that was pursuing me and it was taking over everything in its path.
No! Ah! It's sentient now? Now move out my way, dang it! Ah! They weren't kidding when they said it was getting stronger.
Opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there.
Only 45 minutes left.
That was pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path.
Go!
Of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there. Everything in its path.
house of some sort on the opposite shore. I hope
this game
is
stupid. Yeah, after this is the final episode, I don't even care. I'm not finishing this game. If we had to do this stupid bullcrap, bro, I'm being so serious.
The darkness that was pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in this world.
Okay, goodbye, guys. This is it. I don't care if I can't even get past this section. This is it. Screw this episode. Screw this game. Especially if I had to do bullcrap like that. Screw it. Screw this game. Never playing it again. It's been fun.